Laura here, and today I've got a 10 minute yoga workout for you. It's going to be a nice gentle yoga flow, so great to wake up your body and get you going. So we are going to get started. So feet are together, shoulders are back and down, abs are pulled in, and you're going to turn your palms forwards, breathing in and then breathing out, breathing in through your nose. Grab your right wrist, breathing in, and breathe out as you lean over to the side. And if it feels okay in your neck, look up into the eye of your elbow. Come back to center, change wrist, breathing in, and then breathe out as you lean over. And then arms come down, interlock your fingers, push down, and then come here, push your shoulders back, and then lift your arms up. Try and keep them straight. Just take them as far as you can go. And what you don't want to do, I'll show you from the side, is get to the top and be doing this. You want to keep that tailbone tucked under. So I find this move really, really hard to do. It's one of my goals, is to be able to kind of get to the top. Okay, and breathing out. I'm going to turn to face the side so you can see. Make sure you keep facing me so you can see what's going on. Breathe in. And as you breathe out, we're going to dive down. Half lift, so hands just under your knees. Flat back. Forward fold. Bend your knees. Hands onto the floor. You're going to step back. Drop your knees to the floor. And we're going to come down to the floor. Legs down. Shoulders back. Breathing in. Into a little cobra. Breathing out, knees stay down, push up, and we're going to tuck the toes under and come into a downward dog with our legs bent. So we're driving through our hands, hips are up to the ceiling, knees are bent, pushing our tails up, ears are in line with the arms. And if it feels okay, you can try and straighten them, and then you can pedal one foot, pedal the other foot, and again, and again. And then you're going to bend your legs, look forwards, step in, back to our folding position. We're going to do a half lift or a flat back, forward fold, breathe in, breathe out, and breathe in, and diving down, abs are pulled in, neck is nice and loose, bend your knees if you want. Flat back, forward fold, hands onto the floor, bend your knees to be able to do that. Take the legs back, hold here in plank. Option, bend your knees to the floor, so knees touch the floor, otherwise stay here. And come down to the floor, tops of your feet on the floor, shoulders back, breathing in. Breathing out, tuck those toes under. Option to keep your knees on the floor like we did the first round. Otherwise, push up here into a downward dog. Bend your knees if you want. Otherwise, try and straighten. Pedal. You're going to lift your back leg up. And you're going to bring it forwards, knees to nose. Feel the core working. Sorry, I'm just going to move this hood out of the way so you can see my face. And then opposite leg to elbow. Back up, and then this time we're going to take it round to the side and then back to the middle, and we're going to step it. So foot is flat on the floor, heel is still up at the back. Try and come up now onto your fingertips. Your chest might still be on the floor, that's fine. Sorry, chest might be on your knee, that's fine. And we're going to come up here in to crescent pose, and I'm just going to adjust my top. Palms are facing, shoulders are back and down, and we're here, we're in crescent pose, and we're going to come back to the floor, take the leg back, take it back to downward dog. This time we're going to lift the front leg up, bring the knee forwards, nose to knee, so getting a little cheeky core workout, opposite knee to elbow, back up, same knee as elbow. And then bring it to the middle, step it forward. If you step here and you get stuck, you can use your hand and adjust your foot. So we're here in this lunge position, and then get yourself ready for crescent. So you can come up onto your fingertips and then come up into crescent pose. And just take a few deep breaths here, enjoy this pose. And then we're gonna come down, hands are on the floor, leg is back, options, put your knees down, otherwise keep them off the floor, come down to the mat. Baby cobra, back to downward dog. Back leg is up, so single leg downward dog. Bring the knee forwards, step it forwards. This time we're gonna put the foot flat on the floor. Knees stay behind your big toes. And we're gonna come up in to warrior one. Now back foot is more of a 45 degrees. My little toe is still in contact. Make sure the full bit of your foot is in contact. And what you wanna try and do here is try and square those hips. So we're here, option to stay here. Otherwise, opposite hand to bent leg goes forwards. And this helps you try and square those hips up. Opposite hand going up. And then both hands come up. And we're in warrior one. And then we're gonna turn. So a little adjustment with that foot. And we're here in warrior two. Using this inside of my leg to keep my knee up so it's not rolling forwards. I'm here. Foot is more parallel now. My little toe is still in contact with the mat. Hands are out, and just a few beautiful deep breaths here. And we're gonna come up and then breathe out. Come up and breathe out. Palm up to the ceiling. Breathing in, a little bend backwards, looking into the eye of your elbow as well, if you can, if that feels okay in your neck. And we're here, front leg is bent, and then we're gonna deepen it by straightening that front leg, if that feels okay, otherwise keep it bent. You're gonna go a little bit further, and then bend again. And we're here, and then we're gonna reach, 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 till we can't reach anymore. Hand comes onto your top of your thigh. Other hand is up here. If it feels okay, look on your neck, look up at your hand, otherwise you can keep looking at me. So we're here, okay. And then we're gonna come back to warrior two. We're gonna straighten that front leg, turn the feet forwards, turn the other foot now to face the other way. So this foot is now parallel. My little toe is still in contact with the floor. We're here and we're just gonna bend that front leg. Widen that stance if you can or if you need to. Keep that inside of your leg up so the knee's not creeping forward. So we're here, arms are open. Imagine fingertips reaching that way, fingertips reaching that way. And we're gonna breathe in and then breathe out. Breathe in and then breathe out. And we're gonna reach, 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 reach. Hand comes down onto your thigh, other hand up. Option to look up at your hand if that feels okay. Otherwise, keep looking forwards. And then coming back up, straighten that leg, turn the feet to face you, breathing in. And then coming down. And then just let that neck relax, feeling nice and loose. And then we're just gonna heel toe our feet forwards. And then we're gonna curl up one vertebrae at a time. Curling, curling, curling. Feet come together again. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let's do a couple of neck circles. And then the other way. And you're gonna look one way, look the other way. And again, and again. I hope you enjoyed that yoga workout. It's just a nice flow to just get your body moving, get some mobility back, and just get the blood flowing and get you moving. And also, if you focus on your breathing, it's a great way to calm down your body and help kind of reduce any stress and anxiety. Hope you enjoyed the workout. Let me know, and I will see you soon with some more workouts. Bye.